At first, Friday night appeared to be a flop for Alexander Ovechkin. As it turned out, the kid was happy to take a dive. The Caps got first-rate goaltending from their second-string netminder. And when OT rolled around, one snap of the wrist was enough for OV to trick the Ducks. Today, the Desert Dwellers howl out loud. The Coyotes played like a pack of wild animals to come back in Toronto, a sight which pleased hockey's grandmaster. It's too early in the day to throw in the towel. We're just getting started on Comcast Sportsnet. Skates inside the Glendale Arena as Comcast Sportsnet fills up your daytime television hours with the Capitals clashing against the Coyotes. A very pleasant welcome to you. Along with Craig Lachlan, I'm Joe Beninati. Alexander Ovechkin has had a season full of statement games in his rookie year, but Friday night in Anaheim may have been his loudest one yet.
Well, he carried the Capitals on his shoulders against the Anaheim Mighty Ducks. Speed, power, and finesse, all three exhibited by Alexander Ovechkin. His 28th goal, a wonderful beat on a sit-up by Clarkie. Goes to the backhand of Ichiguera. Dipsy doing a spinorama, 5-goal. And why not wait when the game is on the line in overtime for a snapshot between the defender's feet and the goalie's 5-goal. Ovechkin hit the 30-goal plateau in 43 games. He's one of four Caps to reach 30 goals in less than 45. He joins Pee-wee Maroop, Bobby Carpenter, and Peter Bondra.
That's a pretty good foursome right there.
And obviously, his teammates aren't just innocent bystanders in all this, but it is fun to watch. Brian Wilsey had this on a star-studded performance.
That was probably one of the best I've seen, especially coming off a travel night. He played about 20 minutes the night before, and he's got a lot of pride, and he really leads our team at such a young age, and it's a pleasure to play with him, and in watching that, it was a special night for him.
Ovi loves to score. He has a hunger, a passion, and an unmarked enthusiasm to play the game and put the biscuit in the back basket. He likes his left arm pump and kiss off in most goals. He's animated. He's excited. Simply put, he loves to score, and he loves to lead this Capitals team to victory as much as he can.
And the guys talk about his overall explosiveness, and that obviously includes all of his physical attributes.
Oh, man. He has the speed of a race car and the thud of an 18-wheeler. He'll hit you in open ice. He'll hit you along the walls. I think he'll hit you just about anywhere. The thing that I like about him most, it doesn't matter who you are. Anyone and everyone is a target for Ovechkin.
And earlier today, Glenn Hanlon addressed Ovechkin's tie-turning hit from back on Friday.
It's interesting, Joe, that these players see so many things, and they've played this game so long. There's not a lot of plays that really seem to make an impression on NHL players. But there is, every once in a while, the great players do some things that makes everybody take notice, and that was one the other night.
Now, the Phoenix Coyotes are coached by the greatest player ever to lace on skates, and Wayne Gretzky had his own highly heralded first year in the show.
Let's take a look at the tail of the tape. The great one back in 79-80, 25 goals, 41 helpers, 66 points. OV 11 off the great one start. He has 30 goals and 55 points. Remember, the great one finished with 137 points. Wayne Gretzky, whether it's the World Juniors, Team Canada, he is indeed Mr. Hockey, the greatest player ever, 18 straight times as an all-star, an unheralded streak for Wayne Gretzky. He hoisted the Stanley Cup four times. He's used to that with the Edmonton Oilers.
He's born in Brantford, Ontario, not far from Saturday, from Toronto. So Saturday was a homecoming, and his team didn't start all that well, but they sure finished.
They were down 3-0, Joe, but they seemed to come back with his dad Walter on board in Toronto. Nagy, a nice goal. That tied up the game at 3 apiece. And then Schustrom, the game-winning goal. That relay by Beltmore leads to the wide-open net.
We will not see Cujo today, but you got to figure that the Coyotes will lean on these two down the stretch.
Wow, Shane Doan's been terrific. 12 points the last 10. since he was named to the Canadian Olympic team. He's been great. Cujo will not get the start. However, he does have 17 wins this year.
On the other side of the rink, the Caps got an outstanding effort from Brent Johnson in goal Friday. The former Coyote did some howling on his own in the win. And today, he chomps down against his old friends. Straight ahead next when we return on Comcast Sportsnet. This day and night around the National Hockey League, and ours comes to you from Glendale Arena in Phoenix. On Comcast Sportsnet, it's the Washington Capitals and the Phoenix Coyotes, and Craig has the netminders.
Well, for the visiting Washington Capitals, Brent Johnson gets the nod because of his fine performance the other night against Anaheim. He's looking to go with 4 wins this season and 5 losses if he gets the victory today. Brian Boucher, who missed the first 31 games of the season due to a groin injury, gets the nod over Cujo. An emotional night for Cujo in Toronto on Saturday. That's why Boucher starts today.
Officials Joannette Meyer, Ratsiko, and McKelman on the lines. We are underway. Washington is in the traveling whites. The end of the line on a 3-game road swing for the Caps. They're back home Thursday night to tangle with the St. Louis Blues. Zbigniew McCulloch will get things going for the Coyotes in that brick red uniform. Jeff Sanderson will slug it back behind, and Brent Johnson will tee it up for Jamie Hewitt. It's ripped around the dasher and down, and an early icing call to come against the Caps 29 seconds in.
Not a bad idea early on in this hockey game for Glenn Hanlon's bunch to play a simple game. Remember, this is a Coyotes team that practiced yesterday afternoon, had a long trip in from Toronto Saturday night with Gretzky and his staff alongside Barry Smith, Rick Tocchet, Rick Bonus, a fine coaching staff. They know this first 10 minutes is critical, and it's a good job by the Caps icing the puck. The more they can get out of the flow for the Coyotes, the better off they're going to be this afternoon.
We'll see Jamie Lundmark take a lot of draws today against Dinas Zubras. Right there, Washington wins the first encounter. And once again, is happy to play back onto the Phoenix side of the table.
Well, Lundmark's been pretty good in the faceoff circle, Joe, over 60% efficiency. They like to use him in a lot of situations, especially in the defensive zone.
50-year pro who was jettisoned from the New York Ranger organization. As we move through our first minute of play, a poor clearing pass, and you don't want to give it to this guy. Nagy puts it softly to the goal and wide. Ladislav Nagy leads Phoenix in all major offensive categories.
Yeah, he's the most dynamic player they have up front. 15 goals, 48 points.
Ovechkin fires, and Brian Boucher kneels to deny.
Great shot right there. An excellent stop by Boucher, getting the nod over Cujo. This Phoenix Coyote team knows what to look for when they're dealing with Ovechkin. That's everybody's thought right now in pregame speeches. Heck of a snapshot. Boucher, the stopper, well out to challenge Alex Ovechkin early.
Boyd Gordon flanked by Jeff Friesen and Colin Forbes. And we look through the lineup quickly, Craig, and we don't see Jeff Halpern getting a jersey today.
I imagine he's still banged up with that lower body injury.
As Nedved turns one towards the front, speaking of guys who haven't been getting into the lineup actively of late, Peter Nedved has been in the throes of a long slump.
Man, a big-time doghouse. Just 1 goal the last 16 games for Nedved, and in the doghouse of the coaching staff.
Biron sent it on the way. It was redirected by Gordon off the outside of the cage. Colin Forbes funneling out of the corner. Gordon putting on a move against Sean O'Donnell just back into the lineup after an NHL-levied suspension.
Yeah, 2 games for Sean O'Donnell. Back-to-back, 2 instigator penalties means you have to miss 2 games. He did, but he's back in the lineup. He's a big force back there as O'Donnell.
Wayne Gretzky and Glenn Hanlon will change up on the move as Matthew Biron wanders his way through center. Ben Clymer on ice for the Caps with Matt Bradley here and Brooks Light. Coyotes on the dump down. The veteran Ricci goes after it. Johnson stubbed that clearing attempt, and Heward got killed as a result. Back through center, Keith Ballard, 23-year-old second-year pro, former All-America out of the University of Minnesota.
Yeah, they've got a lot of young defensemen. In fact, 4 defensemen are 23 years of age or younger. The Caps may be able to capitalize on that this afternoon.
The young guys have been getting an awful lot of ice time, too, Locke. As Nash rakes it back into the corner. Spinning there, it's Steve Gainey. Finding another veteran winger in Jeff Sanderson, and he is wedged away by Brendan Witt. Moving towards the 3rd minute of this first period, scoreless in Phoenix, and here comes the game's first penalty. It's going to go against Washington. The Caps go shorthanded right now. We let you know that these are our VHicks.com keys to the game today.
Well, for the Capitals, the more the merrier. They can't rely simply on Ovechkin. He's got five of the last six goals. They need a balanced attack. Screen door, they've got to get in front of Boucher. They need tips, screens, deflections to beat their netminder for the Coyotes. First and 10. 10 minutes critical for Gretzky's bunch. They were talking about it yesterday. Move your feet against the Caps and trap door. They like to institute a right-wing trap. Barry Smith from Detroit, one of the key guys instrumental in developing their system.
Whoa, Brent Johnson had some difficulties with that. Nedved firing from the point. That was partially blocked by Boyd Gordon. It's a Phoenix team that had a couple of power play goals in their rally in Toronto Saturday night. Peter Nedved winding it up. Nedved looking in Doan's direction. So too was Ivan Majewski. First and only get together between these two. The Caps coming in with 14 wins. Phoenix with 22 as you got a quick look at the special teams numbers. Mike Comrie playing the flank for Paul Mara, who early in the season, first 06 weeks or so, was leading this team in scoring. Great centering pass, and Johnson makes the stop on a bang-bang play for Nagy.
Excellent stop by Brent Johnson, a carryover from his last game against the Ducks. He's been very square. He's been challenging. That's when he's at his best. Nagy, you don't want to leave this guy that wide open. There he is, the quick snapper. Notice the push-off with the left leg of Brent Johnson pushing out to get closer to the shot coming from Nagy. Good stop in the power play.
Locker, the Phoenix manpower advantage is just below 20% at home, although they're in a stretch now currently where they're four for their last 37. Brooks Like has another 55 seconds left in his minor for tripping.
You know, it's just amazing. You look at all the power plays. They're so cyclical in the NHL. You're either hot or you seem to be in the other end of the spectrum, real cold. They're real cold right now.
Brent Johnson will tee it up. Little bump set for Brendan Witt. Around the wall but not out. McCulloch broke his stick on that one-timer. Taking care of it is Saprykin, longtime Calgary Flame property. Nagy dumped it back into traffic. Sanderson, a former 40-goal getter in this league, had that intercepted by Witt, and he'll put it all the way back down the pond. The Washington Capitals protecting Brent Johnson during this manpower disadvantage with three shot blocks. Just 10 ticks left in the minor to Like, approaching the 5-minute mark of a scoreless first. Steve Gainey loses the handle. Ovechkin's drive to clear didn't get out. Another point drive that was redeflected wide. Majewski picking up Ovechkin in stride. Lost it there on the curl and drag. Ricci looks ahead on the headman pass. Gainey waits, drops it for Nash. He'll fire, and that's eaten up by Brent Johnson.
Well, you can see the matchup that Wayne Gretzky wants, the Tyson Nash unit, along with Gainey and Ricci against Alex Ovechkin. They like to do halfies. That means half the time one line, half the line the other line. Dinah Zuber's banged up on the bench. He's a key cog, obviously, on the number one line, clipped with a high stick. But look for that matchup today, Joe. He'll send two lines, his number one line and his checking line, to try to slow down Alex Ovechkin.
I like that. Halfies. H-A-L-F-I-E-S. Halfies. All righty. Shane Doan working to the front. Canadian Olympian in Torino in February in a couple weeks.
And I think because of that, when he was named, he's really picked it up. 12 points the last 10 for Shane Doan. I think that weighed on his mind, especially with Wayne Gretzky behind the bench, the top guy in Team Canada and the Olympic team, put a lot of pressure on Shane Doan.
Ken Hitchcock, who's an assistant on Team Canada, would have coached Doan a long time ago in juniors in Kamloops and thinks the world of the young man, who is an outstanding talent.
Well, I think he's a perfect fit. You know, they always talk about when you go to the Olympics, team chemistry and building a team as quickly as possible among superstars. That's why Shane Doan's a good fit. He's great in the locker room and off the ice and on the ice. He does a great job.
Sean Morrison, the beneficiary of a nice bounce there for Brian Sutherby. And now Bradley cruises in, fires off the outside of the cage. Paul Mara keeping a couple of Caps company. Wilsey bumps it back to the point position. Morrison sends it on the way, knocked down there in front of Boucher. Well, that had to be a little bit of interference there. Mara was all over Sutherby, and he didn't have the puck. Referees allow play to continue. Sanderson pulls up. McCulloch with a blast. And Brent Johnson at the top of the crease to make the save. 6 minutes, 44 seconds in, and looking for the first red light in Phoenix.
Ricci trying to get the puck in front. Check out what happens to Dinah Zubris. Here's Steve Ganey's stick, number 14. Papa, now the coach in Montreal with the Canadiens, Bob Ganey. Steve Ganey clips him. No Chicklets lost there, doesn't look like. Zuby wears him out there.
No harm done. Ivan Majewski strolling through the defensive zone to play it on back. Jeff Friesen working in his second game since returning to the lineup for the Caps. The 29-year-old winger didn't play a game, since early November?
I thought he played pretty well, Joe. Over 13 minutes, skated well, didn't seem to have any bumps and bruises or any pain.
He made the comparison Friesen did, as this is an icing call. Jeff Friesen was saying, you know, it's a little bit like training camp for me. All these guys are so much farther ahead with respect to condition.
And I think the big thing now is just to get his hands back. I think his wheels are going to be fine. If you're a great skater, you generally are always going to be a great skater. He certainly has speed and tempo to his game. Now the finish, that's going to be the determining factor when that finish will come to play for Jeff Friesen.
Lockery's working today with Boyd Gordon and Colin Forbes. And this one is brushed off the glass by Majewski and down. And the Capitals have been hit with a steady diet of icing in the first 7.5 minutes.
And behind the bench, Wayne Gretzky. Now the head coach here, also managing partner of this franchise, the Phoenix Coyote. He's been terrific. Scored first career goal versus Vancouver 3 days after his debut, and the guy he beat, the Caps, Glenn Hanlon.
Glenn Hanlon insists he didn't allow it in. He says Gretzky scored. I didn't allow it in.
Okay.
Morrison will clear it.
Those 26-inch pads by 8 inches. Somehow Gretzky got one by him.
Found a lot of room there as the Caps are in the midst of a line change.
I can't believe the horsehair couldn't stop that shot.
Those pads were heavy. Heward.
Yeah.
Connecting with Zubris. Good stick check. Waiting at the line was Denis Gauthier, who has a reputation for being a power hitter in back. Ovechkin lets it fly right to the belly of Boucher and no rebound.
Now, I talk about a forward matchup. The Phoenix Coyotes also worried about a defensive matchup, and that's going to be Gauthier. Gauthier hits like a rock. He's a guy that comes from the right side to the left side, where Ovechkin likes to come down, and he'll sting you. He'll step up hard. He's always done that throughout his career. They think he can nullify Alex Ovechkin if he steps up on him.
He steps up, and he often targets up top, if you know what I mean, as Biron hammers that one wide. Tyson Nash, an agitator of sorts, will play the corner boards. Ganey shouldered by Biron, and that loosens it up for Brendan Witt. If you're just tuning in with us in Comcast Sportsnet, no score today as Witt got cleaned out. Zubris snakes his way into the zone. We have 11 minutes and 30 seconds to go in the first period. Brendan Witt's drive deflected down and wide of Brian Boucher. And this one is lobbed back to center by Ganey. Will give Gretzky the chance to change. Ovechkin's lead intended for Willsey never got there. Ryan Sutherby on the forecheck for Washington. Nagy on the regroup. Zabinek McCulloch had that one click off of his blade and into the seats for the whistle.
Nagy getting a little cutesy in his own zone. Nagy's a guy that loves to have the puck, and he'll love to create plays. There, it just about costs them. Good job defensively by the Phoenix Coyotes, making sure that puck gets up and over the glass. Good pressure early on by this Caps team over the Coyotes. They're playing on the road, and to me, they've dictated the play so far. Not a whole lot of chances for the Coyotes.
This is a Phoenix team, Craig, that has dropped its last two here at home, and both by 5-2 counts to Columbus and Colorado. Ryan Sutherby from long range, no worries for Boucher. Even in full strength, 5-on-5. This is Matt Jones to play. Channeled away quickly by Sutherby as Heward will pinch down. Willsey trying to pitchfork it loose, and he does. O'Donnell smashes him against the wall. Physical game starting to heat up as Muir threw a screen wide of Boucher, who reacted very late. Shots on goal in the early going, favoring the Caps 5-3. Jones will steer it in and turn left for the line change.
Well, this current stretch for this Phoenix Coyotes, three straight at home, 13 of the next 16, I think will determine if they get to the postseason. They need to rack up big points. That's why they're approaching each game as a must win, especially during their long run here on home ice.
It's not going to be easy, though. When you look at all the teams in the Pacific Division, Wayne Gretzky's group is tied for third presently in that division, but they're all above 500. Mara, one hands it around. Coyotes in the brick-colored sweaters. Frederick Sjustrom will regroup. Gauthier will try the other side. And Clymer was waiting. Brooks Light got cleaned out there. Bradley comes in to lend a helping hand. More pushing and shoving. Matt Bradley getting nose-to-nose with Paul Mara. Nimble moves away for Sjustrom. The Swedish-born winger. Brent Johnson will pepper it on around. A big hit that sent Nedved slow to his skates.
And they don't like to see that because Nedved has been banged up all year. He's been out of the lineup. The last couple, however, coach's decision. But early on, it was one thing or another for Peter Nedved.
Year after year, whenever I see Nedved, I think great wrist shot.
Oh, yeah.
Spectacular wrist shot. And Caps fans have felt the sting of it throughout the years. In a bunch of different cities.
A lot of trade rumors floating around. There was one generated not too long ago about possibly going to Pittsburgh. Sergei Gonchar may be coming out this way.
This is brushed in there deep by Boyd Devereaux, 24-year-old Ontario native. Majewski playing the dasher. Clymer, soccer style for Light. Brooks Light, two on two. Light to the trailer, Majewski, and Boucher got that with a goal stick. Rapidly, we move past the halfway mark of this first period. Joe Beninati, Craig Lachlan with you from Glendale Arena in Phoenix. And, Lock, I have to ask you right away, what do you think of this baby? It's the last rink we've seen.
I love the building. I love the fact that it's sort of like Center Molson up in Montreal, Joe. The way the seats are very close to the action. It doesn't sit you way back. I love our vantage point from up here. You're right on top of the ice.
Center Molson, Center Bell, whichever one you prefer.
I'm on the road for a while.
Caps are next at home Thursday night with St. Louis. And after the game, you can meet our own Craig Lachlan back at McFadden's again, apparently. McFadden's Restaurant Saloon in Pennsylvania area, 24th Street. See, I don't think that's right, Blocker. I think you're going to the Grand Slam, 10th and 8th Street.
Yeah, it's going to be the Grand Hyatt Thursday night, partner. I'll be there. Have some fun with some Caps fans after the St. Louis game.
Doan, smoked there by Muir. Even in full strength, 5-on-5. Six shots for Washington, three for Phoenix. So you've got a short walk on Thursday, I can see.
Yeah, but remember, you promised me you're going to drive me home.
We'll work on that.
Okay.
That's to be negotiated.
Okay.
Lundmark into the corner. I know the last couple of days have been very stressful for you.
Oh, it has.
All the Caps at the resort.
It's been tough there.
I'm sure it has been.
Hot during the day, cold at night.
Mm-hmm.
Needed some rest and relaxation, Joe.
Uh-huh. Any herbal seaweed wraps at the salon or
jacuzzi?
Steamer. Go for any
and bike. That was it.
Any skin treatments?
Nothing.
No?
Nope.
Beauty products?
Nope.
Just check.
Half hour in the sun every day, though.
Very important.
Mandatory.
Mandatory. Brian Sutherby
vitamin
on the dump
C.
down.
Vitamin C or D, whatever it is.
McCulloch. Yeah! A crisp lead for Nash, and he's erased by Nolan Jonkman. Centering pass intended for Gainey. Ricci. Deals it for Nash again. Gordon hovering in his space. Penalty call coming here. As Nash was working, they find an interference call. There's a lot of picking and re-picking behind the goal.
I think it's going to be Steve Gainey as Nash tried to come around the net. Gainey, who's his line mate, the so-called shutdown line, trying to shut down Alex Ovechkin this afternoon, gets called with a moving pick. Gainey was just recently called up from the minor leagues. There's a play by Nagy down low, working against Gordon. Here comes the pick right there. It was a moving one that then stopped up, but that enough for the referee to detect that. Gainey in the box for a deuce.
So Washington goes to the manpower advantage. Craig, they only had a couple of opportunities in that overtime win in Anaheim Friday. They were 0-for-2. Alexander Ovechkin had all three goals in that gem of a game Friday night for him. Muir's blast redirected wide. Point positions owned by Muir and Biron. Matthew Biron staring away from Ricci. Zubris rips it right to the chest of Boucher. Then he got the arm up, too, to deny Ovechkin as the net is knocked free from its mooring.
Real good shot by Biron from the point, making sure he got it on net. Boucher, good positioning in the net this afternoon against this Caps power play early on. Here we'll take a look at the Biron play. Watch the puck get kicked back to the point. There's the initial shot. That's Dinas Zubris letting her fly off the half boards. The Caps would like to spread out the PK unit of this Phoenix Coyotes team to try to work some passes down low.
Desert Dogs have allowed a power play goal in 9 straight games. O'Donnell will glance it back onto the Washington side. Just over 6 minutes separating us from our Pulte Holmes intermission report on Comcast Sportsnet.
And Biron gets the jersey because Emminger banged up after that last game when he took the long, hard fall when he sort of toe-picked.
And that was in overtime. It happened very late, of course. This one squeezes towards the front and scores! A weird bounce gives Washington the lead.
McCulloch, a nice shot right between the wickets of his goaltender, Boucher. So McCulloch standing in front, Joe. I think he redirected this, trying to give it to Boucher to cover it up. But Wilsey and company will take it. 1-0 Caps on the power play. OV and company, good job just throwing it to the front of the net. Gretzky can't believe it. Hey, what happened? Did McCulloch throw it in or what? He's looking upstairs to see what went on. Here's Dinas Zubris against Ricci down low. That's a hold and a stick, a little shot in front. And there's McCulloch. To me, got a piece of that. Dinas Zubris should get an unassisted goal.
So the Washington Capitals will take them any way they can get them against Wayne Gretzky and friends. On top by one.
Never a bad idea to throw the puck towards the net. Here's Dinas Zubris with Ricci down low. Looks like Ricci probably threw it there, but Dinas Zubris was the last to touch it, I thought. And that puck is banked in off the defenseman. I thought McCulloch also got a piece. Boucher very surprised, as is Gretzky, the bench boss for the Coyotes.
It's an own goal all the way, and Zubris was the closest to the man who sent it there. So Dinas Zubris will get credit for his 11th, at least in-house. And the Washington Capitals pick up a power play goal at 14-13. Looking for another one now as this one's blasted off the target. Dinas Zubris in the midst of a very good run. He's got points in 7 of his last 9. Ben Clymer looking after Paul Mara around the pinwheel and out. The Washington Capitals just one quality scoring chance allowed here as we have the whistle and a penalty call from the trail official.
And I think the Caps may go on another power play here. It's going to be a holding call. Let's take a look at the goal one more time that has given the Capitals this afternoon a 1-0 lead. There's the puck coming towards the net. And as I thought all along, McCulloch actually gets a piece of it and redirects it past his netminder. Zubris has got his 11th. Hanlon and company go to another power play. Comrie, who has been struggling scoring-wise, heads to the box.
The Edmonton native hits Pine for holding here late in this first period. 1-0 Washington.
And I would think, Joe, in this new NHL, Comrie would be a buzzsaw and be racking up the points, but that's not been the case for Mike Comrie with the Coyotes.
Smaller player, very shifty, good hands. That kind of game should suit him. Biron and Muir again in back. Ovechkin works the off wing, right-handed shot, left wing boards. The centering feed that's deflected away, and the Coyotes will make a break for it. Vladislav Nagy with Doan setting the screen, and Nagy never really pulled the trigger.
And Wayne Gretzky recently said, hey, our penalty killing has been horrendous. So they've worked on it with his coaching staff to make it a lot better. Look for a lot more pressure, especially on the half wall.
Horrendous. They've given up 11 power play goals in the last 5 games. And there's another penalty call coming right now.
And that's going to go against Alex Ovechkin. Definitely an interference call. I think he got tangled up with Ricci, the top guy killing the penalty. We're going to take a look here on our Ovechcam as Glenn Hanlon looks on. Brought to you by Alexandria Buick Pontiac GMC. Watch this little pick right there. Down he goes. That's Mike Ricci. OV can't believe it. He has a seat 4-on-4 for a buck 7.
Alexander Ovechkin, 26% of Washington's offensive output in terms of goals this year coming from number 8. The most for any one player in the National Hockey League. Friesen sends a dipping drive on the way, and Boucher will bowl it ahead. So we are 4-on-4 for the next 50 seconds. A long wrister wide of the former Coyote, Brant Johnson, finished up the 03-04 season out here in the Valley of the Sun. Brendan Witt keeping a close eye on Sanderson. Friesen will retrace his step. Heward intercepted there. Sanderson looks to create off the boards. The pinwheel. A little centering pass for Sanderson. Interrupted by Friesen, and Heward will calm things down.
Well, it's all about puck control. Anytime you're playing 4-on-4, you want to spread out offensively, and you want to play man-for-man defensively.
Clymer drills one right off the defender there. That was Ballard who took a chunk of that. Keith Ballard, former Buffalo Sabre first-round pick. Starts the advance. Right on target to Comrie out of the penalty box. Comrie to the front. Ooh, that was Johnson making the save on the Majewski redirect.
Defenseman getting involved at both ends.
Boys, you're supposed to help, not hurt. As good, we hear a whistle.
Good save by Brent Johnson, flashing out that left toe. Majewski, the redirect on the centering pass from Mike Comrie. Watch Comrie pull up, snap it to the slot, looking for the man going to the net. That looked like Nedved, who tried to get in the seam, not picked up. Majewski breaks it up, but the goaltender has to make a nice save. That's why there's a little bit of smiling going on by Majewski.
Brent Johnson's fourth of the afternoon. Phoenix on the power play, its second try on the day. Brent Johnson had 32 saves Friday night in the win. Zbigniew Mikhalyk, native of the Czech Republic. Around the dasher, there's Ladislav Nagy. He's a Slovak. Nagy to the front, rammed there, and Johnson got a piece of that one as it was Nedved's one-timer. Ballard for Nedved again, 2:14 to go in the first. 1-0 Washington. Ballard straight away, bluffs the blast. Now it's the wrister goal, he scores! Keith Ballard.
Well, the importance of putting the puck on the net exhibited there by Ballard. He had some nice obstruction in front of the net set up by Nedved and company on the power play. And Keith Ballard picks up his fifth goal of the season. An excellent shot. Here he is working it at the half wall. It's going to kick back. He's looking for the slapper. Notice he moves to the left just a little bit. Gets it. Here's a fake and then the wrister. And look at the maze in front. You have a whole ton of legs and bodies. And that baby somehow got through. It looked like it might have been tipped down at the end there by Shane Doan. He's a big body that creates a big-time screen in front of the Caps net liner.
Doan was parked there, along with Brendan Witts. He's got almost 450 pounds worth of hockey player on the Ballard wrister. It finds the cage at 17:53, so matching power play tallies, and we are 1-1 here in Phoenix inside of Glendale Arena. Beautiful facility, couple years old. It seats just a little bit more than 17,600 for an NHL play.
Right next to a huge UFO next door.
It does look like something out of another planet.
Now, when's that open for football?
Boy, you got me. I know they're going there, and they're going there quick. The Arizona Cardinals of the NFL, they're done at ASU, so it's got to be for next fall. Brian Sotheby, eagle eye on the lookout for Sean O'Donnell. Comrie will spin. Wayne Gretzky in the midst of a line change with 70 seconds to go in the opening stanza. Dinah Subris for Washington, Keith Ballard for Phoenix, and we're 1-1. Morrison skipped it over the blade of Ovechkin, and Ballard will once again send Washington packing. The Capitals, they're fourth of five straight against the Western Conference. When they come home on Thursday to meet St. Louis, that'll be it for the Western Conference slate. There'll be no more in the regular season against that side.
Well, Forbes and company trying to get through the neutral zone. Phoenix Coyotes do a pretty good job clogging it up in most cases. They want to clog it up for that guy especially, number 8, Alex Ovechkin.
You were telling me earlier, right wing trap, left wing lock.
mostly a right-wing lock now under Barry Smith because they like their speed on the left side. In Detroit, when he implemented the left-wing lock, his left wingers were sort of faster, and they just wanted to change it up a little bit when he came here to Phoenix.
Chris Clark out there, along with Alexander Ovechkin and Dinah Zubris, and it was Glenn Hanlon who said that Friday night he thought that Zubris and Ovechkin played their best game as far as a three-man line is concerned all year.
And we hope to have alongside after the first 20 minutes their running mate, Chris Clark, who I thought had a tremendous game against the Ducks.
15 seconds away from our Pulte Holmes intermission report. Zubris with a final thrust, snuffed out by Shane Doan. Back through center come the Coyotes in that brick red. Ricci will deal it down, and the first period comes to its conclusion with that horn. Scoring summary in the first period, it was Dinah Zubris with just 5 minutes and 47 seconds left in the first on the power play. Zubris, his last four goals on the power play. And Keith Ballard answers for Phoenix. Coming up during our Pulte Holmes intermission report, Locker will have time to chat with Chris Clark. Tarik El-Bashir is the beat reporter for the Washington Post and the Washington Capitals. I sat down with him. We'll go through highlights and stats with you in just a few moments. A busy time for us on this Martin Luther King Day. The Washington Capitals getting reacquainted with the Phoenix Coyotes. 1-1 after 20 minutes. The Pulte Holmes intermission report is next. Washington's win over the Disney Ducks back on Friday was the first of the new year in 2006 for the Capitals. They're trying to make it 2 in succession this afternoon in Phoenix. After 20 minutes of play, deadlock with the Coyotes, 1-1, Zubris and Ballard on the board. Caps fans, don't miss your chance to test your hockey skills against the Caps player. You join forward Ben Clymer at ESPN Zone in downtown D.C., Tuesday, January 17th at 6 p.m., and you'll get the chance to compete one-on-one against Clymer in ESPN Zone's NHL Tonight. The Pulte Holmes Intermission Report is ready to roll. We get it started with Craig Lachlan and Chris Clark.
Thanks, Joe. Clarky downstairs played a terrific game, you along with Ovechkin and Zubris on Friday. What sort of things do you have to do to be a contributor consistently on that line?
I think a lot of it is, being the first on the puck. Ovi wants to be there as well, so it's us two, we're battling the other teams for the pucks and get it out. And Zuby, everybody on that line, or our line, seems to be able to handle the puck well down low, so we just got to get the pucks to the net.
Now, what makes a great line in the NHL? You think about all the great lines that have ever played. What sort of complement do you guys have to be successful?
Well, you know what, I think as a three-man team, it has to be consistent. Everybody has to be consistent night in, night out. And you look at lines over the years, and that's what they've had. They've never given a day off at all.
Now, this game today against the Coyotes, they sort of implemented a so-called left-wing or right-wing trap, a right-wing trap mostly here in Phoenix. What sort of things does that pose for you getting the puck into the zone?
I think our D has to skate it. If they're going to be holding up like that, our D just skate the puck up and get the red line and get it in. Or if they can skate it into the zone, they have to make that read.
Clarky, best of luck the rest of the afternoon.
Hey, thanks, Locker.
All right, Chris Clark, our guest. Stick around, a lot more stuff on the Pulte Intermission Report. The beat reporter from the Washington Post will be alongside Joe right after this.
It's the end of the line on a very long road swing for the Washington Capitals. 3 games for them, and it finishes up in Phoenix. The action is quiet down at the Glendale Arena. We continue with more of our Pulte Holmes Intermission Report. Joe Beninati, along with the Capitals beat reporter for the Washington Post, Tarik El-Bashir. And Tarik, it's nice to finally kick back and share some thoughts with you. And I should start first and foremost with the Rookie of the Year race. Alexander Ovechkin, Sidney Crosby, Dion Phaneuf. Where do you stand?
Alex Ovechkin has my vote unequivocally. He's been unbelievable this season. I think Sidney Crosby may be the more complete player on both ends of the ice, but in terms of pure excitement, Alex is the guy. I mean, 30 goals in 43 games. Are you kidding me? I mean, I think he's surpassed expectations. He's lived up to the hype, and he's been carrying this team single-handedly all year. I mean, he's on this road trip, 2 games, he has all 4 goals. That's all you need to be, case closed.
From one Alex to another Alexander, I know that the Washington Capitals had visions of putting Alexander Semin together with Alexander Ovechkin. What are your sources telling you? What have you heard about the Semin saga?
I think Alexander Semin is going to be in a Capitals uniform next year. I think everyone in the organization is disappointed that he is not here this year. But, you know, I think as things dragged out and it got to be 2 months into the season, he still wasn't here. I think it's probably a good thing that he's not here because, you know, he would have missed a year of his contract would have run off, and he would have missed, training camp, and he would have come in. Who knows what kind of shape he would have been in. Next year, hopefully he gets here in time for training camp, is in shape, and they can integrate him into the team. It's important to this team's rebuilding process that they have to get him because he's a potential 40-goal scorer.
You keep tabs on a lot of different situations involving the Washington Capitals, and I would imagine that one that is going to crop up very, very quickly as the trade deadline approaches concerns the big netminder in the crease. Ole Kolzig told us on Friday in Anaheim he wants to stay put. What are your thoughts?
You know, unless that's lip service, he's been telling me that for the past month. And I think management, they realize how important this guy is for the future of this team. You know, I think Marty Turco, when he re-signed with the Dallas Stars last month, he really set the, I think he's getting 5.7 over 4 years. He set the threshold for what elite-level goaltenders are going to get. And I think if Ole is extended a contract somewhere in the three-year, $5 million range, I think he stays. And it's important for the future of this team because they're going to try and get some free agents in the offseason. It's important they get Ole under contract long term so they can show these free agents that these guys are serious about winning in the short term.
10 seconds. Will they be in the playoffs next year?
I think next year is probably a bit of a stretch, but, you know, if they get Ole and they get Alexander Semin here and maybe pick up a guy, a first-line center to skate with Alexander Ovechkin, it's certainly possible, but I think it's a bit of a stretch.
Appreciate your thoughts. Safe travels and best of luck.
Thanks, Joe.
That's Tarik El-Bashir of the Washington Post. We are in the middle of periods 1 and 2. Our Pulte Homes intermission report. When we continue, Locker joins me on their side. It's time for highlights. Alexander Ovechkin has scored the first goal of the game, an NHL high 8 times already this season. He didn't do it today. The Caps and Coyotes do each have one on the board, though, after 20 minutes. Our Pulte Homes intermission report continues on Comcast Sportsnet. I'm Joe, he's Craig, and I got to ask you, Locker, that's a holiday Monday. Did both teams get the wake-up call or not?
I'm not sure if they did. I thought they sleepwalked through that first period. I thought they had a tough time generating any type of emotion or generating any type of offense because of their lack of forechecking. Both these teams played very passive. Look for the second period to get their legs under them. The Caps have to, instead of icing the puck, get to center, dump it in, establish their forecheck, stay out of the penalty box, and they'll play much better.
Time for us to look at some Geico Direct highlights from period number one. And it began in a bumpy way for Dinas Zubrus.
Yeah, he got to play down low, working in front. Brent Johnson gets a high stick from Steve Gainey. You'll see some of the anguish here laying down on the ice on the bench. He's saying, ouch, that's smart. Well, anytime you get bumped, the feel-good story is if you score a goal, all of a sudden you feel no pain whatsoever. I've went through that in my career. He gets a lucky bounce. Mikhailik, the defenseman, chips it past Boucher. He scores.
Unassisted at 14-13, and then?
And on the power play, look at Keith Ballard, Joe, just getting the puck through the net. 5 bodies, 10 legs, no chance for the Caps netminder to pick up that shot.
Zabrykin and Mikhailik on the assist at 17-53. Statistically speaking, Washington had the advantage 11-7 in shots, and they only surrendered 3 scoring chances.
And that's a real positive. I thought they were real solid in their own zone. Anytime you can shut down Nagy, guys like Nedved, guys like Comrie, you're doing a good job defensively. The Caps wingers and forwards did a nice job complementing the Caps defensemen today.
Sure looks like the ice is ready for period two. We will be when you return on Comcast Sportsnet. Craig Lachlan, front and center with you for period number two on Comcast Sportsnet. It's Washington and Phoenix today, deadlocked at 1-1. Dinas Zubrus and Keith Ballard on the board. Washington back home to host St. Louis Thursday. Phoenix will also be off until Thursday when they get another visit from a Southeast Division rival in the Florida Panthers. The two teams starting the second period, even in full strength, 5-on-5. Brent Johnson against Brian Boucher in the netminding duel. Gauthier's long blast was answered by Brooks Like and skated from harm. Like and Bradley along with Clymer together for Glenn Hanlon. If you missed it at the outset of the show, no Jeff Halpern today and no word. As there's a jam shot, score! Ben just 30 seconds into the frame.
They must have heard me between periods. Start off this period with a bang. Excellent triangle down low. It starts with Bradley pressure, which leads to a turnover, and Ben Clymer right in front for the redirect. Here's the work behind the net by Light, and he throws it up the short side, and there's the chip shot by Clymer, past the surprise Boucher. But you'll notice the triangle. Bradley on one side, Light on the other, and someone's going to be in front. Well, it's their running mate, Ben Clymer. The chip shot gives the Caps, with his sixth, the 2-1 lead.
Just 30 seconds in, and that was a splendid pass from Brooks Light. Light now, six of his 7 points this season have come away from MCI Center. And that fine first assist gives Washington the advantage back again, 2-1, with Ben Clymer to strike as you look at the happy trio along the bench. So now how will Phoenix respond? Just touching on Jeff Halpern out of the lineup. The Caps are also minus the services of Steve Emminger, and that means a lot of ice time.
It certainly does. And Jeff Halpern about 21 minutes and Emminger about 22. I thought in the first period Morrison got a little more ice time than he normally has. He's up to close to 8 minutes in that first period. So somebody has to step forward and eat up some of those important minutes that Emminger has.
An icing call, and we revisit the early second period strike.
And it's the CBL line getting it done, Joe. Bradley, Light, Clymer. What a great play. And to me, that's Boucher's puck in the first place. I don't think a goaltender that close to the net can allow that pass to come in front. So I'm sort of hanging him out to dry. He's got to have that. The Caps will take it. Clymer has a chip shot.
Something new and different. Locker lynching a netminder as Boucher.
I haven't pulled him yet.
No, that's right. Get him out. Get Cujo ready. Ryan Boucher coming in with 6 wins and 11 decisions against the Washington Capitals. The understudy this afternoon, the veteran 38-year-old Curtis Joseph.
And there you take a look at the goalie ranks for Cujo. Look at all those games. Second active. He doesn't get yanked a whole lot. Third and wins with 413. And in the top five when it comes to shutouts. They got a great tutor here in Phoenix. Grant Fuhr is now the goaltending coach here. So two guys they can learn off of the way he played net in his heyday.
Oh, for sure. As Wayne Gretzky continues to surround himself with some very, very good talent in the coaching department now that he is the bench boss in Phoenix. Boy, Devereaux was straightened up there. A centering pass clicked off of Comrie for just a second, and Brent Johnson was at the ready. Washington out shooting Phoenix to this point, 13-7. Dinis Zubras playing catch with Chris Clark, turning and spinning away from Denis Gauthier, his former Calgary teammate. Then he lost it in the wash. Comrie on for Devereaux. And now Nedved with a weak wrister, and Johnson left a juicy rebound, and thankfully for the Caps, no Coyote nearby.
Not a whole lot of mustard on that shot, but it sort of re-changed directions a little bit and caused problems.
Sotheby had Ovechkin, but couldn't handle the puck for the pass, and Brian Sotheby is scolding himself all the way back down the ice as the Caps touch it up here for icing.
And blaming it on his stick, of course. Anytime you're a hockey player, you put the blame anywhere but yourself. He blames his twig. Great opportunity to set up Alex Ovechkin. There's Ballard wiping out. Loses a wheel, and there's the mishandle. Rolls off the end of Sotheby's stick. That would have been a layup for Ovechkin. Nobody else in front of the net. The mishandle may have cost the Caps a goal.
Dinis Zubras and Ben Clymer on the board, and an immediate penalty here right off the draw, holding the stick, I do believe, against Phoenix.
You're right on. It happens right off the faceoff. And I think it's going to be Mike Ricci nailed, the centerman, the veteran guy. He's going to head off for holding the stick on the faceoff. There you look at Ricci, one of the guys that they picked up in the offseason. Adds a lot of toughness, former Shark. There's the play, and there you see his hand right in there. Easy call as Sotheby's held up. Ricci holding the stick at 217.
Holding the stick with his knees, it looked like, for a little while. Ovechkin's relay for Matthew Bjorn. Back to point position, there's Brian Muir. Muir, the top of the umbrella. Bjorn keeps it on the outside for Dinis Zubras. His last 4 goals, power play strikes. Muir for Ovechkin. Ovechkin to the front. Wilsey was crowding the crease. Alexander Ovechkin through the seam. Zubras fires and scores! A honey of a pass, a rocket of a shot.
Dinah Zubers is loving life the way this game started. He got clipped up high, scores a goal that's redirected by one of their defensemen, and you call it a honey of a pass. Indeed it was, Joe. What a play. Wilsey will get an assist along with Ovechkin. Look at Ovechkin. That's called threading the needle. And you'll see Dinah Zubras just wind her up and beat Boucher short side. There's the shot. Too long for Boucher to come from right to left across the seam. A scorcher of a slap shot by Dinah Zubras.
I'm not trying to get carried away, but that looks like Alfredson to Heatley with that kind of width. The Ottawa power play usually flourishes. The Caps taking a page from those guys, and Dinah Zubras has a two-goal game. The Caps have a two-goal lead.
How about Gretzky to Anderson?
Okay, fine.
There you go.
They could appreciate it, too.
Yeah.
Mara smashing like against the window. Jones gets it out with the help of Jeff Sanderson. Throughout his career, wonderful skater. He lost something, though, as Light will rip it off the shoulder pad of Boucher and off the rink.
What a great start for the Washington Capitals in this second period. Must have been lattes all around in the locker room. There's the shot, short side. Boucher would have liked to push a little harder with his right blade to get across. He doesn't in time. The Caps power play spreads it out, going from one side to the other. Too hard for goaltenders to recover.
So goals for Washington on back-to-back shots, and Alexander Ovechkin has points in 12 of his last 13 with that helper. It is a 3-1 Washington advantage. A couple of goals before the second period was 3 minutes old. Clark spins to the front, had it hatcheted away by the defensive O'Donnell all the way back into Brent Johnson's neighborhood. The reverse from Witt to Huard, fumbling around with it a little bit. And there's Shane Doan with Ladislav Nagy and Jamie Lundmark this trip for head coach Wayne Gretzky.
And this line has not been a factor so far against the Caps. They've really shut down Doan. Nagy's got a couple of shots, but that's about it.
Let sleeping dogs lie. Doan to the front. There's O'Donnell with a rip. That was blocked and a penalty call now. This time it's going to be against Washington.
And there's the interference call by the referee. The Caps up 3-1. And some notable numbers here, Joe.
Go ahead.
26 of the 30 NHL teams have lost games when they have led by two goals or more. The only clubs to have won each game in which they have led two or more goals are four teams. As we take a look at the penalty, the teams are the Sabres, who are 17-0, the Canes, the Rangers, and the Sharks. The only teams not to lose when they have a two-goal lead.
So Washington hopes to imitate those four. Colin Forbes is in the penalty box. The Caps are a man down now as Phoenix gets to go to the power play. Overall on the season, 18% effective. Coyotes here at home at Glendale Arena in the brick red sweaters. This is their third power play chance. The power play marker in the first period from Ballard. Doan with Nagy on the outside. Working the line, it's Comrie. Doan slips it to the wing. Nedved's on the goal line. Sean Morrison looking at him along with Boyd Gordon. Comrie will deliver it. Nedved sweeps it down low. Nagy to the front. They rotate to Mara down there, but the pass doesn't get through. Ivan Majewski does the job.
Yeah, good scampering out of the zone by Majewski. The Caps are allowing them to get that first sharp angle shot, but they're taking away the passing lane. This is a team, the Coyotes, that love to do the bang-bang pass across the crease. Got to have your stick in proper position, the Caps have so far.
Nedved streamlined back in there with Saprykin. Saprykin has wonderful wheels. Keeps it moving for Nagy. Point position for Nedved. Power play, Phoenix, another 40 seconds. Mara with a blast that didn't get through. Dinah Zubras muddying up the water. Zubras with a wonderful effort to play it clear. Now Ladislav Nagy, Slovakian Olympian. Three straight 20-goal campaigns. Finished off there by Witt, and at the line, the officials will say offside.
Actually, no, they have six guys on the
penalty.
Ice, Joe.
Yeah. Too many men.
Phoenix have six guys on the ice. I mean, they had it on there for about 10 seconds. Bad line change by the Phoenix Coyotes. Gretzky's not too happy with this call, so their power play goes for naught with a 1:24. The Caps will have a power play upcoming.
And Craig, and this has nothing to do with the too many men on the ice. Let's go to just Wayne Gretzky from an X's and O's standpoint. From himself as a player, obviously, as wonderful as they come, would you have imagined that he'd be a good X and O in-game guy?
I really do. I think he has such a passion for the sport of hockey in general that it just breeds confidence among his players. They listen to every word that he says on the ice. He's a tough coach. You guys have been benched. When they don't play hard, they sit. He's a big believer in that. He's come in to take this job over saying, hey, if you don't work hard, you're not playing. And that's simply that. So he's made everything black and white.
Something happened there, though. There was a miscommunication. He wasn't pleased about it. Too many men on the ice cost the Coyotes their power play chance. Brent Johnson makes the save there on a bullet from Saprykin. The Caps building some momentum with Boyd Gordon. Ryan Wilsey hits the brakes. Channeled off there by Sanderson. Sanderson looking to counterattack, and Brian Mueller wouldn't let it happen. Just a little bit past the six-minute mark of the second period. It's been a good one for the Caps. They've got two on the board. Ovechkin trying to add to it, and Boucher held the post. Alexander Ovechkin may have drawn another penalty against Phoenix. He did.
And it's going to be a hooking call. Good speed by the Washington Capitals. Now they'll have an extended five-on-three, possibly to salt this game away. Three-goal leads are a lot different than two-goal leads. Here we'll take a look at the play behind the net coming right at you. There's a stick in the gut. It's an easy call. Marr can't complain. Ovechkin loving life. 5-on-3 power play for the Caps.
Paul Maron, his fifth full season here with the Phoenix Coyotes, has a seat next to Mike Comrie. And Washington with that 5-on-3 Craig was speaking about for the next 70 seconds. Ovechkin leads all NHL rookies with 12 power play goals. Dinah Zubrus has two of them today. Biron for Muir. Ovechkin fires the stop. Rebound off Boucher. Two beautiful saves. The last one on Wilsey as he scrambles back into position.
I'm amazed that Ovechkin missed that layup in front of the net. So he has the wide open net. Hit a skate boot of the Coyotes defenseman with Boucher out of position.
Biron tries the other side. There's Muir. Ovechkin works the top of the umbrella now. Now Muir wants to reposition. Ovechkin one timer, kick save. Ooh, rebound just jumped over Zubrus. He had a layup for the hat trick there.
That's two open nets the Caps have missed. Let's hope it doesn't come back to haunt them.
Zubrus to the slot. Wilsey jams it wide. Ovechkin retrieves. Deking away from Ballard. On the back pedal, it's Biron. Ovechkin to a better shooting angle. Biron, Zubrus to the front. Ovechkin waits, fires, and it's squeezed by Boucher just in the nick of time.
And he wasn't sure he even had that baby. He was glancing around him to see if it got through the pad. Sharp angle shot from Alex Ovechkin doesn't get through. The Caps had two glorious wide open nets, and they misfired. The last chance in sight. Here's Dinas going across looking for Wilsey. It goes right to Ovechkin, who sneaks down. There's the high shot. Had it been a little lower, they might have been in a better position, as the Caps have called a timeout, I presume, to settle down their 5-on-3 and to generate some more chances.
Glenn Hanlon's team peppering Boucher during the 5-on-3.
Yeah, four shots. And I'd have to say three missed shots would be a total of seven. Quality opportunities against the sagging Phoenix Coyotes.
Well, here was another one just a few moments ago for Dinas Zubrus.
I'd love to see him get the hat trick. I love the way Muir spins around here, throws it to Ovechkin, slap shot right side. Uh-oh, bounces right over his stick. Dinas would love to have come back. One more look. There's the empty net. Oh, man. Just misses him, goes right between the wickets. Dinas looking for a hat trick.
Prior to today, Zubrus had never scored against Phoenix in 11 games. He's got two this afternoon. Ovechkin at the tail end of the 5-on-3. Fires one, a dart that went wide. The rebound winds up on the tape of Mike Comrie just out of the box, and he'll clear.
Now let's see how this Coyotes team responds. They have not played a very energetic game against the Caps. Sometimes the littlest thing, like killing a 5-on-3, can spur on a team. Let's make sure, if you're a Caps fan, that the Caps match that intensity that we may see upcoming.
They haven't killed it yet. There's still 20 seconds left in the 5-on-4. Gauthier doing his part, floating it back to center. Muir waits for the team to get onside. Boucher will slow it down. 3-1 for Washington on Comcast Sportsnet. Joe Bettinati, Craig Lachlan with you here at Glendale Arena. The Caps erupting for two early second period goals to take the advantage. And now, With Mara out of the box, the Coyote fans salute the penalty-killing efforts. Ovechkin juggles it on in. Centering feed knocked aside. Gauthier was there with Forbes.
OV, not a bad shift of about 3 minutes.
Ooh, he can go.
Oh, yeah, let him stay out there.
He's been at a spa the last 2 days. He's got plenty of energy.
That sometimes tires you out like it did me.
No comment.
Okay.
Nagy there. Washington all over Phoenix with respect to the shots on goal story. Nagy corralled by Gordon. Nedved for Nagy again. Zaprekin from the sharp angle. Ewert had a couple of assists Friday night in the win in Anaheim over the Ducks. Dynas Zubras also had a pair of helpers in that game. He's got two goals today. Washington two better than homestanding Phoenix. And this is a Phoenix team that won the last two games of their three-game road swing. They come in with some momentum.
And they beat a couple of good teams in the Toronto Maple Leafs and the Buffalo Sabres 2-1. Not too many teams are beating the Buffalo Sabres right now.
Well, that Northeast division, save for Boston, is pretty rough. Klimmer on the move. Ben Klimmer, sharp angle. Bad save, Boucher, and he hooked the rebound back into the corner. As we are rapidly moving towards the midway mark of regulation time. Sanderson sets it up. Big rip. Hammered high off the glass. It was Nedved loading the gun. Peter Nedved delaying. Majewski comes over and Sanderson has no room to operate. Ben Klimmer got the second period scoring summary off to a good start. Snapped out of a 12-game pointless drought in the process. Bradley shouldered there by Zabinek McCullough. Both teams at even in full strength 5-on-5. McCullough drifts it softly in there. Brent Johnson will play it high around the window, but not out. And Sutherby will just stroke it on to the Phoenix side of center. Phoenix Coyotes today. Just a couple of real good quality chances, and that's it. Clark burrowing in, fires! Boucher makes the save, and then he'll dive out to pounce on the rebound. 3-1 Washington, the guys in white performing well.
Joe, you were just mentioning about the lack of shots by the Coyotes. Well, here's why. Look at the quick transition by the Caps. The Coyotes only one shot. They're turning the puck over at the Caps blue line and off to the races the Caps go. Great opportunity for Clark moments ago.
And Washington continues to buzz. This line's had a good showing today. Brooks Like in between Matt Bradley and Ben Klimmer. Brooks Like has a multi-assist game for the first time in his career. Friesen keeps it, or rather Brendan Witt keeps it on the outside for Klimmer and down, Like chasing after. Steve Gainey out there for the Coyotes. Jamie Lundmark drifting in on the forecheck. Gauthier to make a break for it out of the Coyote zone. Gainey turned right into a double team as Dynas Zubras was close by. Sean Morrison for Washington. The good speed jetting out of his own zone, and there's Ovechkin. Alexander Ovechkin dodging a player beautifully. Majewski booms one well wide. Alexander Ovechkin before today. 5 of the last 6 Caps goals belong to him. This one goes off of his skate right to Boucher. Once again, he'll cover up. 8.5 to go in the second period. As we look back on some of the goings-on today for Dynas Zubras.
Well, it started out with a big ouch for Dynas Zubras as he was clipped up high, Joe, and then that leads to feeling pretty good later on. Morrison and the Caps very happy right now with the way things have progressed. The Caps have a 2-goal lead over the Coyotes. Stick around, more stuff around the corner on Comcast Sportsnet.
All righty, right off the draw, before we get you back, the Washington Capitals have made it a 4-1 advantage, and Brian Sutherby was all on top of that crease.
Well, again, another turnover by the Phoenix Coyotes behind the net leads to a good cap forecheck and a deposit of the biscuit off the faceoff. Look at the pressure on the D right here. Here you'll see the D turnover on the reverse. Wilsey tries a stuff. Sutherby comes in, and it finds its way underneath the netminder, Boucher. A great job right off the faceoff. Good pressure all around. A bad play by young defenseman Matt Jones on the reversal of the puck detected by Wilsey. The Caps have a 3-goal lead.
So this Washington team, which snapped out of a 6-game losing skid Friday night in Anaheim, obviously wants to bring a win streak back with them to Thursday's contest when the Caps do get back home with the St. Louis Blues at MCI Center. They are very, very solid today in a 4-1 lead over their host, the Phoenix Coyotes. Doan drops it. Nagy, bear hugged immediately by Morrison. As this one squirts loose, making a break for it, Brent Johnson makes the stop there as Comrie was dancing along that goal line, and Friesen will flutter it back onto the Phoenix side. The quick up for Comrie. Comrie with Doan joining the rush. Doan deking around Brent Johnson, centering pass. Nagy is lurking at the crease. Can't get the shot away. Vladislav Nagy stumbling under the check of Boyd Gordon. Comrie for Doan once again as Wayne Gretzky's adjusted his lines a little bit here. Comrie looking over his shoulder. There's Nagy, stapled to the boards. We look down on Nolan Jokman. Nagy cradles it to the point. Ballard keeps it moving. Ballard's a very offensive-minded defender. Good skills. There's Ballard down low. Playing peekaboo with Nedved, and this time it will be Brent Johnson to squeeze.
You mentioned the name Nolan Jokman. He did a good job against Peter Nedved and company, helping out Brent Johnson. Jokman just 1 minute of work in that first period, getting some ice time here in the second, and he did some good work finishing off Nagy in the corner to the right side of the net, punching some guys in front, making his size work to his advantage. A pretty good job. That long-range shot was all the Caps allowed on that forechecking sequence by the Coyotes.
And how tough is it, Locker, when you're not getting that much work to be a physical factor right off the hop?
It's tough because you're worried more about your skating and passing. The physical stuff comes with maturity and confidence, and right now he probably doesn't have a whole lot of that because he's in and out of the lineup. But when he does come in, he has to continue to progress and utilize his size. That's his biggest asset in the National Hockey League.
Palmeiro wins the race. It's an icing call against Washington, and Nolan Jokman awaits his next opportunity. Good day so far this afternoon for Brooks Leip. A couple of assists here in the second period. Clymer, Zubris, and Sutherby all stringing goals together. As you see, it's the first multi-point game of Brooks's career. He wins the draw back for Brian Muir. When the Caps entertained Chicago recently, it was when you were going over 28 minutes worth of work. If you're looking for guys who can pick up some slack with Emminger not available today, Muir could be one of them. Coyotes dump in, doesn't go far. Majeski blocked it back, and here comes Leick with a channel to the net. Boucher the save. Clymer to the front, score! Matt Bradley, it's 5-1.
Total domination by the Washington Capitals, and I'm not even sure if Majeski got that clear in, Joe. They're getting no breaks of the Coyotes. I thought it hit the linesman in the side, bumped up over the blue line, and off to the races. Bradley and company went. Here comes Brooks Leick. Nifty move to the inside to start the rush. He'll have 3 points on the afternoon. Smiles all around. Love it when some of these grinders score goals. Matt Bradley finishes it off. Brooks Leick, a nifty move outside, inside. The Coyote defense are struggling mightily here in Arizona.
Clymer and Bradley had not scored a point in a long time. Fifth goal of the year for Matt. Got to go back to mid-November to find that last one. And four unanswered here in the second period, and Washington has made it very quiet inside of Glendale Arena. Five goals on the board, and none of them from a man named Ovechkin.
And remember our VX.com keys to the game, the more the merrier. I wanted them to spread out the wealth offensively. The Caps have done it well in charge here.
Phoenix 22-21-2 coming in, tied for third in the Pacific. Washington fifth in the Southeast at 14-24-5, and the Caps are all over the Yotes, 5-1. Ganey's lead a bit strong for Lundmark. Wayne Gretzky will be none too pleased. His team not sharp at all this afternoon.
And that may be the total opposite of what he was Saturday. They were down 3-0 in the first. He was thinking of having a tirade, but he didn't because the team played well. I think this period bodes well for him to go in and read them the riot act. They have not played with the type of passion and hard work you'd expect from this hockey club.
Nagy drifting back on the crisscross with Doan. Nedved is in the slot and the pass never got to him. Ben Clymer peppers it off the woodwork, back out to center. Colin Forbes will clear it with 4:58 to go in the second period. The Caps on top by four. We were 1-1 after one. Nagy accelerates. Nagy wide, right on through. Doan was tied up by Nolan Jokman. There's a penalty call coming from referee Brad Meyer. And there's the whistle. Break time for us. The hard-hitting Matt Bradley, known more for his physical play. He's on the board with a smile. In the Caps sweater, the man on the right there, our good friend Jay from the Caps road crew. He's now seen a game, Craig, a Washington Capitals game, in all 30 rinks around the NHL. Making the trip way out west today and watching a good one for Washington Caps fans. A 5-1 lead for the Capitals, who are now going to be two men down in a little bit of time here. Another delayed penalty call coming as the Coyotes threaten. Brent Johnson got the glove up there on Comrie, and then he'll melt it down for the whistle.
And I think it's going to be Chris Clark heading off for the elbow on the defenseman. He got up high as he ran to the blue line against McCulloch. He got the elbow up, and Clark will have a seat. So an extended 5-on-3 now for the Coyotes of a 1:38. Clark has a seat. Here it is right off the faceoff. He's going to run out. Watch his elbow come up right there. His right elbow swings around, catches McCulloch in the chops, picked up by the referee. 5-on-3, Yotes.
And you just know that their fans are sitting back in their seats here inside of the Glendale Arena going, we got to get one here or else. Point position, Mara and Doan in back. Shane Doan from skate to stick. Comrie, Doan, Mara one-timer, it was shanked. He may have busted his stick there in the process.
The way he shot that puck, it certainly looked that way. Didn't collect a lot of oomph with Mara, who's got a hard shot from the point.
He mustn't think so, though, because he's still playing with that same stick. Doan, deep slot. Shane Doan waiting. Finding Comrie. Backhander snuffed by Johnson. Doan, Mara fires. That hit traffic in front. 5-on-3 for another minute for Phoenix. They're down four late in the second. Nagy. Wonderful offensive player. Nagy, Mara on top, Doan, all on the outside. Good work there by Witt and Sotheby. Pinball passing in front came right on by Comrie. Doan steps in. Nedved, all cranked up. Mara, hawked by Witt. Nagy, severe angle. Great play, and Brendan Witt will clear.
What a great penalty kill. The Caps taking away the shooting lanes. They're getting frustrated with the way the Caps are playing them on the power play.
Comrie checking the board, seeing how much time he has with which to work. Wonderful pass there. Mara sipped it wide. Comrie funneling out of the corner. 5-on-3, 10 seconds. Good read by Morrison. Mara for Doan. One-timer knocked away by Gordon. Mara, Nedved on the outside. Mara all by his lonesome, rips it high, and Brent Johnson had the mask knocked off his head.
And Smitty's going to come running out on the ice with Zuby helping him along. Whistle goes immediately. The high, hard blast with Brent Johnson challenging the shooter. Mara gets a little bit of in the chops there. He's smarting just a little bit right underneath his mask as he lifted his chin up. And hit came flying off Joe.
You always worry about a goalie's jaw when he gets hit like this. There's watch this high heat.
Saucer pass, there it comes. Look where he is, though. Great positioning. And let's listen in on this slap shot on the power play. Ouch.
The second click you heard there is the puck hitting the fiberglass in that mask at about 100 miles an hour.
And he's going to need some fixing done on that mask. One of the straps snapped off. Greg Smith helping out there. As Johnny, was Johnny on the spot. Good stop. Not the one he'd like to take it in the coconut, though.
14 saves, Craig. Coconut and all during the day today. Dinis Zubris, earlier we were talking about how well that he has performed. Just have a look.
First of all, he started early in this hockey game. Got a quick wake-up call by Steve Ganey. High stick. Ouch, that hurts. Well, now he's getting better in the corner here. Gets the puck to the front of the net, ricochets in, he's all right. Now he's feeling real good on this slap shot. Now he has no pain whatsoever. Two goals for Dinis Zubris, the Caps off and running.
5-1 against the Yotes.
10 seconds left to kill in what was a 5-on-3 advantage for Phoenix. Working back and hooking off there. A strip. One mark. As Muir puts it around the turnstile. McCullough keeps it in there deep. And the Caps penalty killers with an outstanding job. Boyd Gordon was among those throughout. Despite four Coyote shots, nothing got past Brent Johnson. It stays 5-1 for Washington with 2 minutes to go in period two. Brooks Light towards the goal, wide of a lunging Brian Boucher, who's giving Curtis Joseph the afternoon off. Saprykin deking to the inside. Light turned him over to Biron.
Well, giving him 40 minutes off.
Well, you never know. That's true. You never know. You know, coming in today, there wasn't an active goalie in the league, at least statistically speaking, that had a better goals against average against the Caps than Brian Boucher. But that impressive goals against average has taken a beating, courtesy of five goals in less than 40 minutes this afternoon.
Yeah, he's under two in his career at 6-4-1, 1.81, and a splendid save percentage, 9-2-2, which has not been the case this afternoon.
Closing in, sharp angle. Centering pass, and Johnson got the paddle of his goalie stick in the way. Loose in front with a minute to go in the second. Ricci takes it all the way to a point position. Gauthier swats it towards the cage, and Majewski says, gee, thanks. Majewski leading a 3-on-2 break, but it's not going very far. Doan chisels it back on. An eventful second period for the Washington Capitals. Extremely productive. They opened up a 1-1 game and turned it into a 5-1 contest. Nagy zooming in for a wrister that was spoiled again by Witt. Brendan Witt has to have at least five block shots today on his own. As Friesen powers out of his own end to clear back down. Here's Matt Jones, rookie out of North Dakota. Nagy in his seventh season in North America. Stripped, got ripped off by Muir with 12 seconds to go. Brian Sutherby, one of the goal getters in the frame. Sutherby closing in, and offsides was Brian Wilsey.
Brian Wilsey just a step ahead of Sudsy. A late period explosion by this Caps team looking for number six. Looks very close to being a 2-on-1 for the Washington Capitals. A ton of block shots by this Capitals team. And this Coyotes team looks very frustrated and downtrodden the way they've had to face this Caps team. The one thing about the Caps, they never lay off the pedal. And there's Gretzky, the way he looks on the bench, he's not very happy with the way this team has played here this afternoon. He's already ready to go into the locker room to prepare his speech.
As the horn goes, two-thirds of the way through, and the fans serenade the Coyotes. As the Washington Capitals got it started early in that second period, and I mean early, 30 seconds in, it was Clymer, followed by Zubris and Sutherby and Bradley, a whole bunch of assists to hand out as well, as the Caps outscore the Yotes 4-0 in the second period to take the 5-1 lead. Locker's going to have a chance to catch up with Brooks Light. Wayne Gretzky will be profiled for you in a matter of moments. Highlights and stats and all that and more to come during our Pulte Homes intermission report. On a day when the Washington Capitals are finishing up a three-game road swing, they have the intentions of doing it in style, for sure. Plenty of smiles on their faces. It's 5-1 through 2. Pulte is next. The Phoenix Coyotes relocated from Winnipeg back in the 96-97 season to here in the Valley of the Sun. They've never taken a beating like this from the Washington Capitals here. In the new building for the Caps, it's 5-1 through 2 on Comcast Sportsnet. Our Pulte Homes intermission report, it begins with Craig Lachlan chatting with Brooks Light.
Thanks, Joe. Well, Brooks, I think we should stay at a resort prior to every game. What a second period for you in particular and your hockey club.
Yeah, it was... We had a good first period. We came out tied 1-1. We knew if we could jump on them early in the second, maybe we'd get some momentum, and we were able to get a couple power play goals, and then we got a few breaks around the net, 5-on-5. So we got ourselves a lead going into the third. That's where we want to be. We just got to close it out.
Tremendous start for this period with your line in particular. Walk through and explain to the fans the importance of the use of triangles as we watch Clymer's goal early on in the second period.
Well, it's having two guys up gives you pressure on the puck, and then... Also, you got to have one guy back. On this play, Brad just gets it deep. He goes in, and he does what Matt does. He finishes his check. he gives me the puck, and then I just threw it at the net. I know Benny's going to be going there, so Benny beats this guy to the net, throws it in the net. So that was a big goal for us, a big momentum swing, and you know, we'll use that momentum going to the third.
Comment a little bit about the PK. I thought they were terrific in the second.
Yeah, can't say enough about guys like Boyd, Sudsy, what they do. Witter, he blocks shots every night. That guy's a walking bruise. So, and Brent was kicking back there. He blocked the one with his face there. So, you know, guys are, everyone on our team's contributing here, and we're in the special teams. That's really helping us.
Well, Brooks, best of luck the rest of the way. Keep up the offense.
Thanks.
All right, Brooks, like our guest after 40 minutes. Stick around. A lot more stuff right around the corner. We'll flash back and take a look at Wayne Gretzky's stellar career right here on Comcast Sportsnet.
All time, the Washington Capitals, just one win in six tries in the desert. Looking pretty good, though, through 40 minutes of play today. 5-1 on top of their hosts, the Coyotes. Our Pulte Holmes intermission reporter continues. Phoenix is coached nowadays by Wayne Gretzky. And, Craig, ever since he was a young man, there were thoughts that he was going to be one of the greatest, and he turned out to be the best.
Yeah, Wayne Gretzky, born January 26, 1961 in Brantford, Ontario. Some of his minor league numbers, like when he was that age, 517 points, 378 goals in about 60 games. Gordie Howe, one of his idols when he was growing up, a goal in his twilight of his career with the New York Rangers early on, the motoring madness of the Edmonton Oilers. He'd saucer it across, he'd set up goals, he'd score goals. He's at the top of the list, just about 61 records coming into this season. He held to his own, did Wayne Gretzky.
I guess he worked out pretty well. Moves he started when he was a young man, would continued throughout his junior days, and whatever he was wearing the maple leaf on his sweater, he was fantastic. Wayne Gretzky, 20 seasons in the National Hockey League, a multiple-time All-Star. He led the league in scoring 10 different times and won the Cup 4 as a player.
And notice as a kid, number 9, changed to 99 as a junior hockey player. That has now been not allowed to be worn anymore. It's been retired by the National Hockey League. The Hall of Famer, look at these numbers on our Toyota League leaderboard.
894 goals, so that means Alex is only 860 behind. Good luck, Mr.
How about those points, Joe?
Good luck.
Close to 3,000 in his career.
Yeah, that's pretty darn good, and you have to wish him well after today, at least, as a head coach. It's 5-1 Washington through 2, but we're not through with Wayne Gretzky. Earlier today, it was Brian Wilsey and Glenn Hanlon with their reflections on 99.
I grew up kind of when they were in the Stanley Cups in the 80s, and that was a hero of mine. And you know, it's pretty neat to see that he's getting behind the bench for them and doing a good job. It's a few of us on the team that are his hero. Not a lot of Ontario guys, but a few of the Western guys as well. But it's pretty neat to see him doing that.
We always respected the fact that Wayne went out of his way to be a gentleman off the ice, and he walked a very tough road. It was very difficult for him, being a young player, to be able to have all the demands put on him, and he never seemed to be in a bad mood. And for that, all of players like myself, we ended up being looked upon as our sport being the best players or the best people to get along with, and we attribute that to Gretzky, and he opened up a lot of doors for us, and for that we're grateful. As a goalie, and I wasn't really grateful for all the goals he scored on me, but I guess that's part of the business.
He is still, though, Wayne Gretzky, a wonderful ambassador for the sport.
And against Vancouver in his career, Joe, 117 games, 76 goals, one of them against the Caps bench boss.
More than one. 5-1, Washington has the advantage. 5-1 through 2.
That's
stick around.
A shot.
No, it's not. You'll want to see highlights right after these. Almost 90% of the Washington Capitals' goals this year have been scored by guys in their 20s. All of them today. 5-1 Caps through 2 against Phoenix. We continue with more of our Pulte Holmes intermission report. Joe Beninati and Craig Lachlan with you. And Craig, it's nice when the Caps' work ethic gets rewarded, isn't it?
Yeah, and that's what's happened in today's game against the Coyotes. The Coyotes have not won any of the wars of the walls. The Caps have totally dominated. They've got the puck in deep. So there's been some turnovers by the Coyotes defensemen that are uncharacteristic. Even though they're young, they haven't been making blatant mistakes. It's the pressure that the Caps have put on them that they haven't been able to handle.
this game has been all Washington Capitals. That second period, Joe, the best I've seen from this Caps team this year.
It was 1-1 after 20 minutes. It wasn't going to stay that way very long in the second, just 30 seconds in for Ben Clymer.
And it's a great play. The triangle down low, starting with Bradley to Light to Clymer, and he chip shots it over the goaltender. One more look at this nice play in front of the net.
For Ben, that's goal number 6.
And Dinas Zubrus, what a shot, but it all starts in a picture-perfect pass. You called it a dandy. What a play across the scene.
Dandy, honey, whatever I said. It was Dinas Zubrus' second of the day.
You know I don't listen to you.
Never.
Good play by Wilde down low. Sutherby comes in for the rebound. You should have said dandy. That's what I meant. And there's the shot underneath the goalie.
We all had a dandy call on that one.
No, that was a honey.
Yeah, right. Sutherby with his marker at 11:39.
Brooks, Light, nice weave to the middle. There's a juicy rebound. Bad coverage in front. Bradley's got an open net.
Matt Bradley right there. Beautiful feed for his fifth at 13:41 in Wayne Gretzky.
Are you sure you want to be a coach?
Just loving it or not. Washington all over Phoenix in terms of shots and chances.
Look at those scoring chances. That's pretty impressive. I'm impressed with the Caps 17. Equally impressed with they've only allowed the Coyotes on their home ice 7 chances through 40. A wonderful job defensively.
Couple more power play goals for Washington to boot in this 5-1 lead through 2. 20 minutes to go in the road swing when we get you back on Comcast Sportsnet. First of 3 straight here at home for Phoenix, and they've fallen flat. 5-1 Washington as we get set for the start of the third. Couple nights back, the Caps looked very good. Just after lunch, Glenn Hanlon gave rave reviews for the effort.
Oh, well, I think it was the one game, I think, this year that I felt everybody contributed. When you take a look at our wins here, it always seems to be Ole's had to make some great saves, and we've always had to look at maybe one of our specialty teams playing a little better than they have in prior games. But I thought last game was great. Our defensive coverage was great. We played very well on the penalty kill, and Johnson had to make enough great saves, but certainly not out of the ordinary.
Brent Johnson today, under Glenn Hanlon's direction, 14 stops. That win Friday, Alexander Ovechkin, all 3 Caps goals in a victory. Only Dennis Marouk, the only other Cap to ever have all 3 goals in a Washington win. And Alex, we understand, has been given today's first goal.
Yeah, that we thought was going to go to Dinas Zubrus. I guess Dinas did not touch it as a defenseman or the forward covering down low fired the puck at the net. Dinas doesn't get credit. It reads Ovechkin is 31st unassisted, so he has a 2-point day against the Coyotes.
7 other games going on this afternoon and evening around the NHL. A holiday Monday, Martin Luther King Day, and the fans inside of Glendale Arena have been stunned into silence by 4-second period goal for the Caps. A 5-1 Washington lead as we start the third. Joe Beninati and Craig Laughlin with you inside of Glendale Arena for Comcast Sportsnet's continuing coverage of the NHL. Tip of the cap to the men and women in our crew today. Gainey knocked down by Muir. Brian Muir and the Washington Capitals are going to be one light on the back line here for the remainder of the contest. Jamie Huard is out.
Yeah, lower body injury.
Uh-oh. Brooks Like.
Oh, was that an upper body injury?
Upper, lower, middle? Never heard of a middle body. How about a middle body injury?
It's one of those, but he's not going to be back in the third.
As Jones makes a touch-up, it's an icing call against Washington. This is a Caps team coming in fifth in the Southeast. Brooks Like with a pair of helpers. Ben Clymer gets back on the board. He was the guy who really started the spree in the second.
Good work all around from this line. Brooks Like set a real strong game. He's been aggressive. He's been good on the face-offs. He's been dishing wide, but I like the way he's got some get up and go. He's making some moves going outside, inside. That created one of the Caps' goals.
Right now, he's back-checking on Jeff Sanderson. For so many years throughout the NHL, Sanderson a threat coming off the wing with his good speed. Here he collects a pass from McCulloch and floats it right to Brendan Witt. Brian Sutherby cruising in. Sutherby's wrister well wide of Brian Boucher, who remains between the pipes for head coach Wayne Gretzky and the Coyotes. A takeaway. Saprykin floats it into space. Just a bit behind Frederick Hustrom, who's played sparingly. Sanderson guns one in as the Coyotes will change it. Jeff Friesen, Saskatchewan native, in tight quarters with Sotheby, and he'll just trickle it below the Phoenix goal line. Nagy steers it for Doan. Shane Doan. Letting Nagy power into the offensive end. Not creative enough there to deke away from Morrison. Zubris turning in and trapped offside was Chris Clark.
Well, Dinas Zubris has been given credit for two goals by us early on, but here's the dump in by Ovechkin. Now, the key factor, did Dinas touch the puck as Ricci chips it towards the net? I honestly thought he got a piece of it with his backhand. That's why I gave him credit for it. One more look. Watch as Ricci gets it. And watch Zubris spin around on the backhand. Here it comes. Zuby's going to spin around right there. And to me, he got a piece of it. But they've elected upstairs to say no, he didn't get it. So Ovechkin's got his 31st.
Since Alex played the puck in from the blue line last to touch it, and then the own goal goes in off the two Coyotes players.
Prettiest goal he's got all year.
Yeah, well, so super. Wonderful. Another multi-point game for the 20-year-old Russian, who has points in 12 of 13, goals in 11 of 13, on and on and on like a broken record. He leads the league in shots on goal overall. As the Coyotes wear their brick red today here at home, Comrie looking Devereaux's direction, former Red Wing. Boy, Devereaux surrounded by Brian Wilsey. A number of the Caps getting in the scoring act. Wilsey finds his name on the score sheet too. Comrie with a nice little back heel there. That looked like a soccer pass for Devereaux. Erased by Wilsey.
That's the first time in this game they've really mentioned Devereaux a whole lot, Joe.
Nedved with a blast, and that's waved wide by Brent Johnson. Closing in on 3 minutes gone by in the third. Gauthier waits. Leaves it in the corner. Devereaux looking to stuff, and Brent Johnson had the skate against the post.
And this is a good line change for the Phoenix Coyotes. They've changed around the lines. Notice Comrie was on the Nagy line earlier on in the second period. Well, Gretzky, I think, went in and made a wholesale change among all his front lines.
Right now they're working the cycle game for Comrie. To point position, Gauthier bombs away. Pad save, Johnson, and he's got the rebound.
The real first signs of pressure all afternoon have come in the early parts of this third period against Brent Johnson and the Caps. The Comrie line with a couple of new wingers, Nedved and company, did a good job hemming in Wilsey and his line mates. Some good pressure by the Coyotes, but no pay dirt. There's a look at Comrie. He's a small guy, but he can wheel and deal. Notice the end of his stick, Joe. One of the few guys in the NHL that doesn't use a whole lot of tape
for
better control.
Comrie, 14 goals on the season, second best on this team to Ladislav Nagy. 3.5 minutes gone by in the third, 5-1 for Washington. So with that goal taken away from Zubris, five different goal getters. Doan, harassed by Yonkman. Washington in the white. And Zubris goes one-on-one against Mara. Dinas Zubris working wide, lowers the shoulder. Mara does a nice job to wedge him against the glass. Zubris knocked down. Clark wins the battle, but his pass for Morrison will get away. Sean Morrison has been around the Caps plus-minus lead for the last month. Floats it back into the defensive zone. McCulloch wastes no time getting it out.
And notice who he was out there with, Nolan Yonkman. And I think this is good for his development. Now that it's fewered out, good for Yonkman to get more ice time. In a game that the Caps have well under control at 5-1, feed him some ice time. And I think that's what the coaching staff's going to try to do with Yonkman, their big defenseman.
And Caps fans haven't seen the number 11 out there, the Capitals captain, Jeff Halpern, who was scratched today. So he's somewhere in the stadium, watching his group perform admirably to the tune of a 5-1 lead. Muir ladles it on out. Majewski on the boards for Clymer. Ben Clymer's a very good golfer. I'm sure he was on the links during the couple of days at the spa salon.
There's a lot of guys on the Caps that are good golfers.
True. Sanderson spun around and down. I need to find out who won the tournament. Ben Clymer told me in the past that he's pretty darn near a scratch golfer.
That'll do it.
Yeah, that'll work.
He's had a good hockey game. The Caps have come here to work. They put their hard hats on. Anytime you're on a vacation, I call it a vacation.
Listen to you.
Well, a couple of days on the road that you're spending away from home, that's a good thing. You take a look at the Capital Improvement. Most goals scored on the road this season. 6 in a shootout victory at Atlanta. 5 today. They had a good rest at a tremendous resort, Joe. I enjoyed staying there. I know you were with your mother and enjoyed the home cooking there.
I sure did.
We had a tremendous time without you.
Without you.
Go ahead.
There you go. I appreciate that. And I will remember it.
And thanks for dinner. That was great.
Shoestrom. Oh, last night you bought?
No, at your mom's house.
Oh,
thanks.
No.
I love meatballs, and I heard she's the best, so thanks for the invite.
Yeah, like you were going to really come 50 minutes away from your palatial golf resort and spa.
Had I been invited.
You would have said, no.
Had I been invited, stranger things have happened.
I know. You would have been airlifted by helicopter. Glenn Hanlon looking on. 5-1 for Washington. All the scoring coming back in the first two periods, and the majority of it in the middle frame. This Washington team 10-0 when they allow two goals or less, and right now they're looking good. As Sotheby gets ready to draw. Brendan Witt turned back by Devereaux. One touch passing and Comrie drifted it wide. Jones will cheat in from the point position. Wilsey will just play it back to center as the Coyotes give some ground. This Phoenix team had a winning record at home, 6 of their 7 years in the desert. They come in just over 500 today overall, tied for third in the Pacific. Boston Bruins picking up a matinee win today in overtime in Beantown over the team that Washington just bested, the Mighty Ducks.
And that's after Carlisle called an illegal stick to go on a 5-on-3, two bang-bang goals, and they tied it up 3-3 in the third period.
Gordon lets it loose off of McCulloch. Follow-up chance, and Boucher was ready with the blocker against Matt Bradley. A little bit more than 14,000 in attendance this holiday Monday afternoon in Phoenix. Washington will board the plane as soon as we're through today and make their way all the way back from west to east tonight. And then set up shop for the St. Louis Blues. Good seats still available for that one Thursday at MCI Center.
And the Caps and the Coyotes right around the league average so far this season. They were coming into today, 3,905 goals scored, Joe. That's an increase of 24% from 03-04, where the average was right about 4.9.
Here comes Ovechkin with a mad dash. Boucher made the save. Clark wiped out on his pursuit of the rebound. Alexander Ovechkin. Stepping inside, got spilled there, and it's going to be Nagy on his way to the box. When we come back, it is a Washington power play on top by 4. Well, guess who's coming to dinner after all? Or maybe a saloon near you. The Grand Slam at the Hyatt, 10th and H Street. On Thursday, Mr. Lachlan will be there entertaining. All Caps fans are welcome.
Right after the St. Louis Blues game, I'll be there immediately following.
Holding court and carving me up, I am sure. You are oh so kind.
And you know me oh so well.
You are such a team player.
Yep, there's no I in team.
There is a me. And as Zubris works in offside, we hear the whistle. Jay Leach, one of the Caps assistant coaches. Brother Steve, a former Cap, turns 40 today.
Yeah, good teammate of mine, big right winger, always tried to take my job away. I made sure I put him in the wrong direction. It's Steven Leach now up in Boston doing a lot of hockey schools, working for some financial firms. Doing a real nice job with a nice family up in Beantown.
I'm going to say it's a real good hockey family, the Leach family, as Ovechkin tries to play that one into space.
And I think Steven's the only one without the name Jay.
On a carom, it's Shoestrom shorthanded. And that is thwarted by Brent Johnson. Moving towards the 8-minute mark of the third period on Comcast Sportsnet. Washington comfortably ahead of Phoenix on the road today by a 5-1 count. Caps with just 5 victories on the road all season. Should they hold on, it'll be the first time that they've won back-to-back away from MCI.
Well, Brent Johnson has been very comfortable here. He's still got a home here in this area, and so he's got great comfort. He looks very solid between the pipes from the drop of the puck today.
I noticed the Arizona plates on that beautiful ride of his.
Oh, yeah. There's no salt on that car.
No. Witt on the reversal for Ovechkin. Washington amended the good for another 45 seconds. That left in the minor to Nagy for tripping. McCulloch. closing ranks on Ovechkin. Ballard will rip it all the way back down. Shots on goal favoring Washington, 28-17. We were 1-1 after one if you're just tuning in, and then the Caps explode for four in the second. Klimer, Zubrist, Sotheby, and Bradley all in a row to take the 5-1 lead. Ballard, heave-ho, away you go, the length of the ice. Sanderson, and this is going to be called and brought back into the Phoenix zone. Aquavelva, fresh face time, and we focus in on the play.
He's had a real strong game here, going into that CDS line pivot position, taken usually by Sotheby. They perform well. Bradley, the pressure, like the puck, Klimer on the doorstep. Nice redirect. I like that move right there. Outside, inside leads to a great goal in front by his running mate, Bradley. Brooks Light is our main guy here today. He's had a tremendous hockey game. He's skated hard, he's taken the body, he's been good in the faceoff circle.
And the Caps genuinely like it when someone like Brooks Light performs to this level. Well-liked guy in and around the dressing room. Obviously, the effort level that he can put forth when it gets rewarded with points is greatly appreciated. And this is the kind of game that everybody can savor. Caps haven't had very many of these ones where they are comfortably ahead halfway through the third, as this is an icing call. There is something about an Aquavelva man.
There is something about Brooks Like and the way he plays on the road. You can't call him a homer. 7 of his 9 points have come away from home. Plus 6 in the last 20 games. He's been solid and diligent in his own zone. His first career 2-pointer this afternoon against the Coyotes.
22-year-old former Ottawa draft pick, acquired by the Caps in the Peter Bondra deal a couple seasons back. Shane Doan will send it in. Coming Olympics in Torino. If I'm not mistaken, Shane's cousin is the outstanding speed skater, Katrina LeMay Doan, also of Team Canada. And throughout Winter Olympiads past, Katrina has been hauling back the medal. Doan picking up Lundmark for a blast, stopped by Brent Johnson. And the rebound played from harm by Morrison. On the move, it's Chris Clark. Galloping in, and then this turns out to be a 2-on-1. Clark, short side, knocked down by Boucher. Rebound, a wild scramble in front. The officials say play on. Back from the Coyotes, 2-on-3. Nagy drifting. Gave it up. Zaprykin got there late. And Washington is able to play clear.
Yeah, Phoenix having a real tough time putting together some passes. This is a team that Gretzky put together and modeled it after the Tampa Bay Lightning. He worked a lot with Muckler, as did John Tortorella. They don't like to carry the puck a lot. They want it to be a passing team. That's not been the case this afternoon. The Caps have taken away the passing lanes, forced them to skate, and had a lot of good pucks away.
Brent Johnson with a flashy save there, Craig, on Mike Comrie. Good reflexes on display by Brent Johnson, the 28-year-old Michigan native. Looking to backstop. He and his mates to win number 15 on the season, and just the second for Washington in the Valley of the Sun. Their only other win, you got to go back to December of 2002 over at the old building, America West,
where you could only see the ice from three sides. The one end, obstructed view seats. Couldn't see the net right down in front of you.
And awfully close to the end boards, right?
Yeah.
A little fear factor on a slapper that was deflected into the balcony. Brent Johnson saying it would be icing, but it's going to be washed out now as Nash got there first for Wayne Gretzky's Coyotes. Phoenix trailing by 4 with 8:15 to go in the third. Jones keeps it hot on the outside, and Brendan Whitspin everywhere for Washington to play clear. Ovechkin storming in. Alexander Ovechkin curl and drag to the backhand. He scores! Simply sensational!
I thought he did it all the other night. Well, this is a carryover. This may be his prettiest goal of the season. Goal number 32. Even Wayne Gretzky, the great one, is going to see how this one went in. A spectacular display of stick handling on his back, and he hooks it past Boucher. Talk about a celebration. Here he is. You think everything's closed down, going against the D. He's on his back, and he slides it into the wide-open net on the backhand to boot.
Here he is, taken down. Look at him get the puck and just fire it through the outstretched arm of the goaltender Boucher. What a goal by Ovechkin.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is the goal of the year. We have a winner. Don't even bother to send in your votes. Ovechkin, 6-1 Caps. Well, even Alex was giggling about that one. John on that mouthpiece just a few moments ago. An absolutely breathtaking tally gives Washington its sixth goal of the contest. They had six early in the year, although it was by credit of the shootout win against Atlanta in Atlanta, 6-5. They've got six on the board right now against Phoenix with 7.5 to go. And when they play it back over and over again inside of Glendale Arena, the oohs and ahs are amazing coming from the fans. Loose in front. Gainey had a great chance and he whiffed on it. And as the Caps will play it clear.
Some good claps defensively by the Washington Capitals, making sure they work hard still in front of Johnny. He settled right in. There's nothing better for a goaltender to have a 5-goal lead. You can settle in. You know if you make a mistake, you're going to be fine. Brent Johnson having a real nice third period here, just sitting back and relaxing.
As Witt scales it in with 7 minutes to go. A control breakout now for the gentlemen in the brick red sweaters playing here at home. They'll entertain Florida. The Coyotes will on Thursday. Devereaux in. Devereaux fires right to the belly of Brent Johnson with no rebound. Just a few moments ago, what we were talking about, Alexander Ovechkin, I don't know how he does this.
No, it's just spectacular. It's just a freak of a play. Could only be done by the Caps number 8. Notice we were doing a lot of celebrations at the top of the show here today on Comcast Sportsnet. Well, there was a delayed celebration because he was on his keister rolling over into the corner. It was already in the net, and he got up and said, oh, I better celebrate, and he kissed off his 32nd goal of the season.
To do that, you almost have to break your wrist to be able to make that shot over your head on your back. Are you kidding me? Jeff Friesen for the Caps to play. Only as far as the Phoenix line. Counter-punching back comes Devereaux. He's walled by Witt.
Well, I think Ovechkin indeed was looking forward to play in front of the greatest player ever in the NHL, Wayne Gretzky. And he used this third period to demonstrate just how great he is in front of the great one, as he even watched that goal and marveled at the Caps' rookie sensation scoring that goal the way he did.
Well, Alex paid tribute to 99 during the week leading up to this contest. His hockey hero, as Biron sends it towards the front, knocked away by Jones, the great Maltsev of Russian Red Army fame. But Ovechkin knows of Gretzky's heroics full well. Jones powering into a rush, an exit pass that gets away and really just underlines the story for Phoenix throughout the day. They have not been sharp. Alexander Ovechkin, one highlight after another, but this one just may take the cake. Almost 60% of the Caps games this year decided by one goal, but the game summary shows you something entirely different today. Washington, most ever tallies at Phoenix. Ovechkin, another three-point game. Brooks Light all over the score sheet as well. And what has to be a very satisfying end of the road swing after the Caps got it started in Dallas, the first period that fell with a thud. The Caps have played two very strong games in Anaheim and in Phoenix. With just over 5 minutes to go in the third, cruising 6-1. Sean Morrison goes pedal to the metal back through center. Caps playing without Jamie Ewart here in the third period. We understand from Caps media relations a lower body injury. Also without the captain today, Jeff Halpern, who was scratched with no word from PR.
And also Eminger, who loves a ton of ice time, so the blue line sort of a makeshift bunch back there, especially with Emmy, who takes a lot of the important minutes for the Caps back line.
And we can isolate that injury to overtime on Friday night as Brad Johnson squeezes. 6-1 for Washington. Things really changed in the second period.
And it started 30 seconds in. Nice play. Brooks Light climber. Chip shot. See you later. And then on the power play, how about this passing exhibition? Ovechkin, Zuby-Dooby-Doo. Did he ever do that one? Slap shot the back of the Klein. Those are the two guys. Catalyst for this Caps running away
this afternoon against the Coyotes.
Dinas Zubras, after yielding his first goal to Alexander Ovechkin, that crazy one off of two Phoenix players. Zubras now has 11 on the season. He's never had a 20-goal campaign in his 10 seasons as a pro.
And by the way, I would have never expected this, the way the Caps have come back after losing to Dallas to win these last two games.
The Ovechkin performance Friday night with all three goals and the overtime win, and then a total team effort today on their way to downing Phoenix. Lundmark to the deep slot. Nedved was there and shouldered aside by the veteran winger Friesen. As we dip below 4 minutes to go in this one at the Glendale Arena. Wilsey took a hard hit from Gauthier. Play gets stalled below the goal line. Like and Wilsey playing catch. Nedved there with a poke check. Like a dog on a bone. One more time for backpedaling Bradley. And Boucher makes the save, his 26th on the day.
There's another usage of the triangle there. That was a moving triangle down low. Call that a cycle by the Washington Capitals. And Bradley opens up and gets a tremendous slap shot. What is that? That's a face of a hockey player right there. A little cut on his noggin, on his nose, a black and blue eye on his right eye. All around, he's the guy that works in the trenches for the Caps.
Yep, that befits his style of play. Ben Clymer rakes it out of the corner. Bradley sent it wide. There's a penalty call coming, and it's going to go against Phoenix. In the final minutes of this fray, as Jones makes the touch-up, we hear the whistle from the referee, Brad Meyer.
Well, the Phoenix Coyotes running around in their own zone a little bit. Good pressure by the Washington Capitals.
42 minutes for hooking.
And it's going to be a hooking call. So the Caps have a power play opportunity. Face off to the left of Boucher. Good opportunity. Mike Ricci. Gretzky can't believe it. He's often animated behind the bench. Mike Ricci will have a seat. He's a movie star now. He had to cut his long locks. You notice there? He is. He played Elmer Locke in the Rockets movie, Rocket Richard, and had to cut his hair this summer. There's a guy that doesn't have to cut his hair.
Rick Tocchet, don't mess with him.
Oh, man, one of the coaching staff. He took over for Wayne Gretzky after the death of Wayne's mother. Had some time off. Tocchet was the guy that led this team and did a heck of a job.
And Wayne was at the funeral of his grandmother just last week.
Yeah, bad 3 weeks for Wayne Gretzky.
Ryan Sotheby, a severe angle shot that gets spun out of there by Gainey, comes all the way down.
And it's a good mixture on their bench, Joe. You know, you look at Wayne Gretzky, obviously the number one guy, but then they have Rick Bonus, who's been around a while. The top guy is Tocchet, and then they got the so-called professor in Barry Smith. He's very analytical of the game. It's a good complement of their coaching staff.
Came in today, the Coyotes did. Winners of their last two. They got waxed by Ottawa to start their three-game road swing, but then came home in good form and then ran into a buzzsaw today as the Capitals have blitzed them to the tune of 6-1 with 2:20 to go in the third. 1 minute, 5 seconds left in the minor to Ricci. Brian Sotheby accelerates wide. Sotheby to the front. Gordon trying to swat that one out of the air. Sotheby hooks it on back for Morrison. Pawned out there wide for Witt to bomb away. As Glenn Hanlon has not put Ovechkin on the ice in this power play at all.
And why do that? I mean, it's 6-1. It's a good job, I was just going to mention, by the coaching staff. Spreading it out, giving some guys that don't get the opportunity in tight games to work with the man advantage.
Only two Caps in history have ever put back-to-back hat-tricks together. Peter Bondra in 99, Dennis Marouk in 1980. Ovechkin's got 5 goals in his last two games. Light. Corralled there by Gauthier. For the two today for Alex, one was a cheapie and one was really not. As Like sent one wide, Bradley to the goal mouth, and it's twisted out of there by Nash, but not clear. Witt fires, Patse Boucher, rebound loose. And Sobrykin will race away. A lead just a bit strong for Ricci out of the box.
And that's a perfect example of what's went wrong with the Phoenix Coyotes in this hockey game. There's going to be a minor penalty doled out to the Washington Capitals. I think it's going to be Brendan Witt in the late stages here. And there's Wayne Gretzky. Not sure exactly what went wrong, but certainly he's going to have a talk to the coaching staff tomorrow, as Brendan Witt has a seat.
Wayne Gretzky, the managing partner here in Phoenix, not too pleased with the way his team has performed. The Western teams have the toughest road trips, a lot of travel. There you look at his career awards. Just add them up. 9 Hearts, 10 Art Ross, 4 Stanley Cups. Mr. Hockey, the great one behind the bench today.
This is a point you made earlier back in the first period, though. Wayne and his gang will have plenty of time at home in the next few weeks to get things sorted out. 13 of their next 16 right here in Glendale.
And he joins a long list of great players that go into the coaching ranks. You look at Frank Robinson, you look at Bill Russell, you look at Larry Bird, Larry Robinson, Brian Trotche. Some have success, some don't. He wished he would have been coaching 3 years ago, though. When you talk to him, he loves the idea of coaching his team.
Power play for Phoenix to end this contest. O'Donnell keeps it on the outside. Good centering pass there for Nagy. Nagy, one of three different guys with 7 power play goals to lead the team. Nagy repositions it. Back to the front once more. O'Donnell lets it fly, and Brent Johnson stepped out well. Brent Johnson is about to put together back-to-back wins and down his former team. He's got 21 saves.
And he's going to start Thursday when the Caps play St. Louis.
Craig Lachlan, color analyst, head coach, GM, executive director, all of the above. As this one comes to an end mercifully for Phoenix.
That was fun, wasn't it?
It sure was. It was a great couple of days for you in the sun.
Yes, it was. I enjoyed that. What a great effort by the Washington Capitals. 2 of 3 games on the road with W's. It's going to be a nice flight back to Baltimore.
Well, we had a lot of people we could choose from, Craig, for our Microsoft Player of the Game, but he's done it again. Alexander Ovechkin, another multiple-point performance. He had 3 today with 2 tallies.
Why does he get it again?
He's pretty good.
That first goal or the second goal?
I think the first goal was a gem. Second goal was a little iffy.
He's just racking them up. Remember, in the history of the NHL, Joe, there's been only 13 rookies in the NHL to hit 40 goal marks. Only 13 in the history. He's at 32. He's going to get the 40 for sure.
Comcast Sportsnet coverage of Capitals hockey today has been brought to you by Geico. A 15-minute call could save you 15% or more on car insurance. By Alexandria Buick Pontiac GMC, we're all about you. And by Pulte Homes. Pulte Homes has 15 new home communities in the D.C. metro area. Visit Pulte.com. Locker, I hope you get a nice cushy seat on the way home. I'm sure you will. Always manage to do that.
I have a massage set up.
Yeah.
In flight.
For Greg Lachlan, for all the men and women in our crew. Joe Beninati, thank you for your time. The Caps all over the Coyotes. 6-1 the final. You're invited to join us Thursday. 7 o'clock, Comcast Sportsnet. The Caps return home. They'll be facing the Blues. This has been a presentation of Comcast Sportsnet. Alexander Ovechkin leads Washington through the Valley of the Sun. Not a happy day for Wayne.